The Taylor series definition and a discussion about interval of convergence. So we saw that the Taylor polynomial of the nth degree for f of x at x equals a was equal to this, and where those coefficients were the derivatives of f evaluated a divided by the power factorial, the k factorial. So written out, you get this. So that's what the Taylor polynomial was, or is. The series, all that does is extends these terms to infinity. So you just put the plus dot 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 and keep on going in that same pattern. And you write it in series notation, f of x equals this series right here. Your derivatives of f evaluated at the a over the k factorial, which is matches up to the power x minus a. But that equal sign right here is only good for x values such that the series converges. So if the series doesn't converge for a given x value, then that equal sign is not equaled anymore. Some of these series we'll see, f of x does equal this series for all values of x. Others we'll see they don't, only on certain x's. And also you must have all derivatives must exist at x equals a. Otherwise these coefficients don't exist. So example one. For f of x equals sine x, we found Taylor polynomials for sine x at x equals 0, and we extended that, this was the pattern, and we just extend that to infinity, and you get that series right there. But we can't just go around saying equals. We have to know where it is equal. So, for which values of x does this series converge? We do the ratio test. There's your ratio test in action there. You just have to be careful about these factorials. Absolute value of the factorial. These are all positive numbers, these factorials. So that's why there's no absolute value there. Comes over to being this, which equals this, and then we take the limit as k goes to infinity, x squared factor out, get this, goes to x squared times 0, which equals 0, no matter what x is. So the limit of the ratio of absolute values of successive terms of the series equals 0, and 0 is less than 1 in the ratio test, and is such for all values of x, because x squared times 0 equals 0 no matter what the value of x. Therefore, sine x actually does equal this series for all values of x. So that equals is solid. The radius of convergence is infinity. The interval of convergence is negative infinity to infinity, or all real numbers. Example 2. We saw that the Taylor polynomials for f of x equals log x at x equals 1 had this pattern, which I'll remind you later in this video of why that was. So extending the terms to infinity, we get this series here. But we can't just go around saying this is equal, and we'll have to find out what x values it's equal for. So we saw that the interval of convergence was 0, less than x, less than or equal to 2. The radius of convergence was 1. Hence, the equal sign in the log x equals the series is only good for x such that x is in this interval, 0, less than x, less than or equal to 2. So when we put equals, it's understood that it's only equals when this series converges. Here's a reminder of where those terms came from for log x. I'm just going to show the screen here, and you can pause it here. So this is where they came from. Then why the interval of convergence is this was because we did the ratio test. And we got this for the preliminary. And then we tested the endpoints. Testing the endpoints. At 0, we did this already, so I'm just going to show it here again. We got all this. Came out that it was the negative 1 factored out. Negative 1 times the harmonic series, which was this. So that diverged. So x is not 0. And then at x equals 2, we went through and found out that it's the alternating harmonic series, and that did converge. So x equals 2 is good, hence the interval of convergence was 0 less than x is less than or equal to 2. So that equal sign right up here, only good on that small interval, 0 less than x less than or equal to 2.